The MG-42, easily one of the most iconic and deadly weapons of World War II, prominently featured in many movies about the beach invasion of D-Day. Bridges, easily one of the most iconic architectural structure. Railings, easily one of the most famous stabilizing structures in the human toolbox. The sky, absolutely one of the most important and iconic structures of Earth. That oxygen, baby, muy bene. Clouds, easily one of the most water-filled structures in all of the atmosphere. The sun, definitely one of the hottest and brightest things closest to Earth. All of these concepts are crammed together into this very epic and very large, totally accurate battle simulator, Bridge Battle. Yo guys, what's going on? It's your boy DaleyTactics here, back with some more totally accurate battle simulator, and today we're gonna have MG-42s defending a bridge against every single TABS faction, and therefore every single TABS unit. This is part of the new totally accurate battle simulator update that came out recently with the custom unit editor, something I am absolutely loving, and I hope you guys are as well. The past few videos have seen some awesome responses, so I'm very glad to see that people are digging it, and if you dig this video, please be sure to smash that like button. Let's try and get 1500 in the first 24 hours. Subscribe if you have not already. We're trying to get 250,000 subs by the end of the year, and comment down below what TABS battle you want to see next. Either way, the first battle that we're going to be doing today is the Tribal Warriors here, and let's get it going. Alright guys, going ahead and pressing start right now. Let's check out how these MG-42s work against this tribal army. MG-42s and TABS are kind of weird, actually. They fire, and you'll see that pretty soon as this mammoth charges, they fire in like almost a shotgun spray instead of as individual bullets going out, which is very bizarre for a machine gun, but I suppose it was like a way of representing the sheer power of a machine gun, you know, the sheer amount of bullets that can be sprayed out at once by making them like just shotgun spray fire. I don't know why they did it that way, but it just tanked that mammoth. Oh, the mammoth's gone, dude. He's just gone. It straight up shredded that woolly boy. Holy cow. That was absolutely insane. And the kick on these things, dude, check this out. Ready for this? Oh, well. Actually, the tribal army clapping with a couple of, not arrows, spears right there. More coming in, all missing. That could have been an easy clap of the battle if a lot more of those had hit. But actually, only one of them hit, and it actually hit his gun. So I don't think that counts as damage right there, which is pretty bad for the tribal unit. Pretty good for the Germans. Oh, but there goes the banner bearer. That means these guys are now going to be unleashed, and they can walk forward if they so please. But yeah, the clap back on these MG-42s, the blowback, the recoil is so extreme that it literally launches their bodies backwards. It's absolutely insane. But these guys are just getting really lucky with these dodges, to be completely honest. Another spear hits, but it hits the gun again, which results in it not implanting in this guy. The guy does get thrown backwards, and he's kind of doofing right now. He might actually roll over the edge, which would be a good kill. But these spears are so unlucky for the tribesmen and so lucky for the MG troopers. Look, another one hits the gun and doesn't stick. Holy cow. The MG troopers are getting so lucky in this battle, dude. It's insane. All right, they're gonna win, I think, the first one. Tribesmen not pulling their weight there very well. It seems like they're all dead. Oh no, there's one brochachki, one protector unit out here who needs some dying. Oh, but these guys are slow. And this guy's definitely gonna die to him. They're just gonna shoot him in the face. But they're so slow, it's gonna take like 10 minutes. The MGs weigh him down. All right, you know what, we're calling it for the MGs. 1-0 for the MG units against every other TABS faction. All right, the farmers. This one could actually be a little bit interesting here, considering the fact that the farmers actually do have some pretty powerful units. First of all, the most annoying unit in the entire game, the wheelbarrower, he could blitzkrieg these guys. The Germans could find themselves getting blitzkrieged. Also, the poisoners get some early poison on these guys, which is pretty good for them. That means these guys might slowly but surely die, and the bannerman might go down pretty soon. Additionally, these hay balers, I think, can survive these gunshots. Let's find out. Where'd they go? Where you go? Ooh, it looks like he broke his neck. Guy might be dead. Wait, they're all face planted. Actually, I think they did not. Oh, they did survive! They're alive! The hay balers can survive! I will survive! Yeah, buddy, alright! Dude, farmer boys might be able to succeed in this. These three MGers, they're actually getting clapped. Oh, one falls to his death right there. The railing did not end up keeping him up right there. Oof, Scarecrow Man getting some burbs out there. These crows, man. I think they just shot their own bannerman. Friendly fire. Dang, son, that's cold-hearted. Oh, another one does go down due to a burb. And this one is... He tried so hard to take out the burb, but the burb bit back and destroyed him, really. Wow. Look at this dude. This dude just clapped some cheeks. Absolutely insane. All right, well, 1-1 for the MG-42ers. Look at this. Darr. Okay, the knights. Yes, we are the knights who say, nee. Oh, okay. Arrows being a little bit more effective here than the spear throwers and the poisoners. Immediate KOs right there on two MG-42 troopers. This guy's like stuck in this position. Oh, catapult comes in and wipes out the banner bearer. He is dead. One MG-42 trooper left alive. He does get one pretty decent shot out right there. Let's see the effect. Yeah, it definitely did KO a lot of troopers. Hopefully it KO'd some archers. It does seem like maybe a few, but this guy's got to get some more shots out here fast. Nope. Oh God, why? Oh, that's brutal, dude. Not cool. All right, the archers and the catapult here, really effective. Annihilated those MG-42s, and that's just wrong. Come on, guys, have a heart. So MG-42s versus other range units, it's a tough battle. 1-2 for the MG-42s right now against other tabs factions. The Greeks, another faction with a lot of range units. This could prove to be kind of difficult again. However, the ballista is different than the catapult. The ballista really requires shooting straight forward, which, you know, if you couldn't tell, they're kind of blocked by these guys. So that could be tough. Snake archers. Oh my God. Well, that dude panicked. He obviously hates snakes and flew over the edge. The other guys panic shooting the snakes as well, also trying to help out their banner bearer who got wiped out by the snakes. But it seems like they did end up taking care of the snakes right there. They're still alive and they managed to fire out at some of these ancient Greek troopers who were coming at them. That guy's just rolling off the edge. No, my friend. Uh-oh, this guy. Oh God. Okay, he recovered. He's getting more shots off. The kick is really hurting the MG-42 units right now. Oh, snakes, dude. The snakes result in them flying off the edge. All right, the ancient Greeks do manage to catch a little dubski right there and annihilate the MG-42 units, but they did take some serious losses in the process. The Vikings. This one might be interesting because they have a lot of melee units, so that might actually result in an MG-42 victory here. However, I could see the Valkyrie doing a lot of good things, and the Ice Archers could definitely do some good here, so let's find out. All right, good first round for the MG-42s right there, but they keep on getting knocked off the edge because of the kick on their weapons. That is really, really bad thing for these guys. They do manage to take out a lot of those troopers. That Valkyrie is still alive. That could cause some serious pain for them, but it's looking like we might get an MG-42 victory here. No, what are you doing? They panic shot. Oh, they kill the Valkyrie, but like a couple of buffoons, they panic shot themselves off the edge, dude. they are not holding this bridge very well, and I think it really is because they keep panic shooting. There really wasn't that many troopers left. Literally, one shot into this Jarl, and I think he'd be dead, and then these guys, they're nothing. These are the paddlemen for the longship. They're trash. This should have been a victory for the MG-42 units, but they were too much of bozos. And that one dude, he just needed to shoot once and he'd be fine, but he like shot like 8 times at this Valkyrie. Oh my goodness. It's heartbreaking to watch. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it, my dudes. Dynasty might be an L for the MG-42s. Dynasty has some of the most effective ranged units in the entire game. That, case in point. Case in point, the Huacha. The Huacha comes in, completely destroys one of the MG-42 units, damages the other two, and does end up killing their banner bearer. Look, this guy even cut his leg. Tragic. Tragedy. Tragedy! But they do manage to actually get some kills here. Yeah, second round of Huacha. Oh! Did it miss every shot on them? Oh, that's lucky. Look at this guy. Alright, this is not proper weapon management, sir. You are going to break your arms. You are going to break your arms. I can promise you that. Oh, God. The firework archers are getting in here now. Oh, my God. His arms are broken. Oh, look. They killed the dragon. Okay, here comes the Huacha. That's a kill. That's a kill. That's a kill on this guy. Oh, my God. Did every... Nope, one... Yep, they did end up hitting. I thought he was going to miss every single shot, but no, they did end up getting decked by a number of bullets, and they were already weakened by the rockets. Yeah. Dynasty too powerful. Dynasty too powerful. This one will be interesting. The Renaissance. They do have a lot of missile units, but I'd argue their missile units aren't fantastic. So the muskets do end up getting one of the MGs right off the bat. Balloon archers managing to hit the MGs. Are they dragging them up? They are very heavyweights, so they might not even drag them up, which would... Oh, that one got the kill. That one got the kill. No. Yes. Good. Good shot. No. And then he gets hit by the musket fire and dies. Dude, they're not pulling it off. They're not pulling it off. The harder the factions get, the less and less these guys are doing well. MG42s, y'all were supposed to be beasts, but nah. All right, let's see if the MG42 team can hold off against the pirates here. Pirates will be interesting. They do have a lot of range units here. All right, one MG unit dead, but the other two doing pretty strong. Oh, it's that cannon, though. It's so powerful, it's able to one-shot them. If it gets another shot off here, you're done. Oh, it missed. Oh, my goodness. He might have it. Don't get hit. Oh, he juked another cannon shot. Oh, there goes the Pirate King. Oh, don't go off the edge either. What are you doing? What are you doing? Now's not the time for trick shots. Pirate Queen taking damage here. Oh, this guy's dancing around like a gosh dang buffoon. Oh, don't go over the edge. Oh, the Pirate King's actually still alive. The cannon is down, which is great. It's big news. Don't die. Oh. Ooh, he's dancing with the devil. I think he just killed the Pirate Queen. Oh, no, the Pirate Queen's still alive. No! God! You literally... They are on 1,000 times weight. And they still get knocked back. You literally cannot prevent these guys from knockback with this gun. The gun is so powerful that even if you cap out their weight, which prevents them from being knocked back with other weapons, it doesn't do anything because it's such a powerful gun. Because it's shooting like 50 bullets at once. Oh, the knockback loses it for them again. I'm telling you, the knockback, even with the railings, they're falling. Oh, it's bad. The Wild Wild West, baby. Wild Wild West will be interesting. They are... Oh! Oh, that was big! Did they get all their range units? Ooh, that's big! There's still a few dynamite throws. Oh my god, even the banner bear is getting in here. Oh, he just got decked by a cactus, though. Well, look at these chumps. It's like the Three Stooges over here. What's with you and the trick shots, buddy? Just get up. There you go. Oh, he's gonna die, though. Oh, I called it. He didn't die. Never mind. Oh, they do have a gunman, actually. They do have a Deadeye gunman. That could be the downfall of the Three Stooges over here. Ooh, you gotta get close, buddies. Just kill the lasso man. Just kill the lasso man. What are you doing? Kill. Oh, lasso man died. Oh, that guy turned... black. Weird. Oh, shot in the tummy. Bruh. They don't have good range either. I don't know why, but these MG-42s have terrible range. So bad. Spooky boy time. Let's get it started here. Time for the spooky faction. I mean, they didn't win against the knights, so I think that's going to be pretty telling for this battle as well. They're getting some kills, though. They're getting some kills. It's not bad. I mean, the fact that they're holding their own against many more units than themselves is pretty impressive. However, the cost is still the same. I've been setting it up so the cost for the MG-42 is the same for all the enemy units, pretty much. Roughly, give or take, maybe a couple hundred. So, it's pretty bad that they're Oh, they won one! This guy ended up on his head. Yay! We have another victory! But, yeah, the cost has been roughly the same, but they're still getting kind of thwacked, so... Alright, it's legacy unit time, and since there's so many legacy units, I decided to do just one of each of them. And in addition to that, no god units beyond Thor, but like literal god units, like the Super Boxer, the Dark Peasant, and the Super Peasant. They're too powerful, man. They are too powerful. Well, the tank decimated one guy, and the Baron of Bear died there as well. Yeah, they went down. Legacy faction is such a powerful faction. It's actually absurd how powerful the legacy faction is, so... That was kind of to be expected. Yeah. This will be interesting, though. We have the Super Boxer here. So we'll see if they manage to hold off this guy, who is basically a god unit. Oh. Well, it's technically a dub. There you go. I mean, considering the fact that, you know, I called it a dub for the enemy whenever these guys fell off. The fact that they were able to push this guy off, I'm calling that a dub for them. Nice. I mean, Dark Peasant, they don't stand a chance. I'm sorry. These guys are, yeah, okay, bye-bye, yeah, that's it. Super Peasant might be interesting, because this guy has been known to fly off. And I'm just saying it could happen in this battle. Nope, Super Peasant won. Super Peasant clobbered them. Oh my god, as always, the god unit's so powerful. So powerful. Look at this guy, he's doing like a first base skid. Skirt! Skirt! Actually, you would never slide on first, wouldn't you? Because you can extend over, so I guess this would be like home plate skid. Skirt! Alright, guys, that's going to be about it for today's video. I do hope you enjoyed. I had fun doing this, even though it was goofy and clearly not well-balanced for the most part, but still really fun. Still fun to see. So, thank you guys for watching. Subscribe if you haven't already. Smash that like button and comment down below your thoughts and opinions on the video, and I'll see you all in the next one. Peace!
I hope you guys enjoyed that video. Be sure to click that subscribe button for more content, and hit the notification bell if you'd like to be alerted to whenever I live stream or upload. Thanks so much!